Aleluia. Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let our spiritual understanding be enlightened.
Amen.
Open our eyes to behold wondrous things out of the Lord.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Make us a shining light.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you.
In the mighty name of the Lord, receive you, Jesus.
Amen.
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 It's our seat. God bless you. Happy New World and Happy Easter. Hallelujah. Let's open our Bible to Revelation chapter 1, verse 18. Revelation chapter 1, verse 18. And he that lives and was dead. And behold, I am alive forevermore.
Amen.
And have the keys of hell and of death. Thank you for our message. Jesus is alive. Someone say Jesus is alive.
Jesus is alive.
Jesus is alive.
Jesus is alive.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He's alive. In Luke chapter 34, the woman went to the sepulchre, but the account of Luke, and the angel that stood there to the river side said, why do you seek among the dead? Said, behold, he is risen. Hallelujah. Someone say, Jesus is alive.
Jesus is alive.
Amen.
Amen.
In Philippians chapter 2, from verse 9 to 11, Baptist, therefore, if something happened before that day, he took the form of man. He counted it not God to be God, he saw. Yes. But he came, just like he heard on Friday, he sent the message on Friday, he was the son, Peter. He came in the form of man, so that we would be partakers of divine nature. So he came and he said that he sent them was the one that also sent me and he might feel all things. So he died and he goes on. So that he will be Lord even over things. So he said, therefore, God has highly exalted him and has given him a name that is above all names. And at the mention of the name, at the mention of the name
Jesus,
every knee must bow, every knee should bow, of things in heaven, of things on
earth,
and of things beneath the
earth.
Why? Because he was and is in heaven, he's Lord in heaven, he came to the earth, and he became Lord of earth. And he went beneath also. And he became Lord also. Even beneath. Because he conquered death. He conquered the grave. So he said, I have the keys of hell and of death. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
So that every knee bow. And every tongue confess that Jesus is Lord. To the glory of God the Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Jesus rose from the dead with great power. The Bible says in Romans chapter 1, verse 4, he was declared to Son of God with power according to the Spirit of holiness by the resurrection from the dead. Hallelujah. Amen. The grave could not hold him captive. Death could not hold him captive. In Acts chapter 2, from verse 23, I'll read, 23. He said, he was talking about, Peter was talking about Jesus there. He being delivered by the determining counsel and the foreknowledge of God, you have taken and by wicked hands have crucified and slain, whom God has raised up, having loosed the pains of death, because it was not possible that it should be held by the clutches of death.
Yes.
Shout hallelujah! The Bible says he left the captivity. Psalm 68, and also in Ephesians chapter 4, was making reference to what David said. Hallelujah. He conquered him that has the power of death by tasting or being a partaker of death. So death will not hold him. The grave, the tomb of Joseph of Arimathea could not hold him down. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Amen. If death could not hold him down, no death can hold him down.
And the world was made flesh.
He was revealed to us. We beheld his glory, glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and God of many manifests in the flesh. God was justified. He was vindicated in the spirit by the power of resurrection from the dead. Hallelujah. He was seen by angels as our path of the gospel. Hallelujah. He was preached unto the Gentiles. That's a very core event. So the Gentiles ordinarily, you know what Jesus said to the woman, the Syrian woman, the Canaanite. He said, the bread of the children, you don't keep them to dogs. Oh my, thank God for that woman. He said, Lord, even the dogs can from the crumbs that fall from the table. My, what a great woman. Jesus said, what? Even the children that have access to the bread, everything, they are, you know, they don't even cherish what they have. Look at this woman, just a crumb. She held on to it and she was able to tap into the power of his resurrection, quickly her dead or even that child. Hallelujah. How about we have a full dose of the power of Christ? You have the Holy Spirit sitting inside of you. The essence of the celebration of resurrection is not just to be canvassing around and saying, oh, it's to display the power of the resurrection of the dead. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
That power is at work in you today. And you will make a great change in your generation.
Yes.
Through the power of the resurrection.
Yes.
That is at work in you. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. So he was preached among the Gentiles. And he was believed on in the world. And he ascended to the heaven of the glory. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
Before I turn this message to close, I would like to identify the implication or importance of Christ's resurrection. And I have just four. I just want to limit it to four. Now, when I am talking about the implication or import or significance, what are those? The only one that comes to me. I'm talking about the benefits and the responsibilities to see to that the resurrection of Christ please the most. The benefits, the privileges, the rights, and also the responsibilities that are placed on us.
Amen.
So the first one, you walk in the newness of life through the resurrection. Like I said, they are much more than this, but I just decided to leave them this one. So through the resurrection of Christ, we walk in the newness of life. Romans 6, verse 4. Therefore, we are buried with him by baptism into death, that life as Christ was raised up from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in the newness of life. Hallelujah. Receive grace to walk in the newness of life.
Amen.
Receive capacity to walk in the newness of life.
Amen.
All things are passed away. All things have become new. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I want to declare, I receive grace.
I receive power.
To walk in the newness of life.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. supply. Receive it in the mighty name of Jesus. Number two. Henceforth, we live. We live, or we must live for and through Him. We live, or we must. So, it is a privilege. We live through Him, and we must. So, you are, as a result of your being, because you are in Christ, then man be in Christ. So, you abide in Him, you dwell in Him. So, it is a function of who you are, where you are, and also of. Also requires a conscious effort to continue daily, to exercise yourself unto godliness. Hallelujah. Amen. 2 Corinthians 5. Believe for and through Him. 2 Corinthians 5. He says, and that we die for all, that they which live should not henceforth live unto themselves, but unto Him which died for them and rose again. Hallelujah. So your living is no longer for yourself, but for Him. Hallelujah. Apostle Paul also in Galatians chapter 2, still under the same point, Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. Okay. Oh Jesus, thank you Lord. Galatians chapter 2, verse 20. I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I. I love that conclusion says, it is no longer I that live, but Christ that lives in me. Hallelujah. He said, nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ that lives in me, and the life which I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself to me. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. For the secret to live for me. For the secret to live in Him. For the secret to live with Him. And to live through Him. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The third point, we become Christ's brethren through the resurrection of Christ from the dead. We become His brethren and also joint heirs. You know, having become His brethren, we become joint heirs with Him. So we become partakers of whatever Christ has access to as the Son of God. Before Christ was the only begotten Son. So that was the investment that God is an investor. God invested His only begotten Son. So that you will have many sons, except the corn of which falls and dies, it abides by its own. But if it dies, it will bring forth much fruit. That was exactly what happened at the cross. Water was released, but many were not born Christ. the anointed to fight, but as a result of that, many cast. You know, the devil got to the right. He said, without the power of the Spirit, he saw none of this world, which is the priest of the world, you know, is the mystery today. And they know they would not have crucified the Lord of glory. You know, the devil was smart. When Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto myself. If them the right, they pack all the Jews, pack all the seats or whatever, pack everything. But he thought, you know, by killing Christ, by having him to fight, they stop that move of God. The move that has been perfected before the foundation of the world. Amen. So through the death, the burial, and the resurrection of Christ from the dead, we become his brethren. Hallelujah. And I want to open that for us in John chapter 20. John chapter 20, verse 17. John 20, 17. When Mary Magdalene, when she heard Jesus' voice, she heard that it was Jesus that was calling her. So she wanted to claim the name. And Jesus said to her, touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren. How did they become his brethren? Through that resurrection from the dead. Because this is a prototype that the power of my resurrection dwells in you. That as I have resurrected from the dead, you will also resurrect on the last day. But not just that power of resurrection lies in you. So you are not waiting to have the power of resurrection on the last day. You already have it in you through the resurrection of Christ from the dead. If you believe that, shout hallelujah. Amen. So he said, go to my brethren and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father and your Father, and my God and your God. So that is, through this, my Father becomes your Father. And that's why Paul said, we have not received the spirit of fear unto bondage, but we have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. Hallelujah. Amen.
Amen.
And Romans chapter 8, verse 29, also, he said, for those whom he foreknew, he predestinated to be conformed to the image of his Son. Hallelujah. So he predestinated to be conformed to the image of his Son, that Christ may be the firstborn among many brethren. So Christ is the firstborn, and we are his brothers. And also in that same Romans, if you read previous verses, you will see the connection, how we as children of God become brothers. Join heads, you become heads of God, and join heads in Christ through the power of his resurrection. Hallelujah.
Yes,
amen.
Amen.
And also Hebrews chapter 2, verses 11 and 12. You can just write that down. We read that on Friday. You can write it down and read it later. And number 4, we are free through the power of his resurrection from the dead. we are free from the clutches of death. You see, the essence of the resurrection of Christ. I want to have a change of heart today. By the power of the resurrection of Christ from the dead, I choose not to be a casual 21. I want to bring that resolution in your heart. Maybe up to now, all the people just come to church on Sunday and worship, you know, just come practically, you understand what the worship is in the church. You just come to sing, clap, and everyone to do our family, and you drop the offering and this summer and you go back home. No! There is more to your life than that. So the power of his resurrection should stir up and wake up something in you. Don't die away. Don't languish away. I'm challenging some of the things here today. It might sound harsh, I'm sorry. But I believe that God is calling you out of that comfort zone. He's calling for something inside of you. Your generation is waiting for the manifestation of a grace that God has put in you, that only you have. Don't let it die out. That's why you are listening to this message. Not to hear it and go back as if nothing has happened. God forbid. I pray this is set up for you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. So you are free from the clutches of death. Death has no victory over you. Romans chapter 8, verse 11. That's the fourth and the last one. Said, for if the spirit of whom that raised of Jesus from the dead dwells in you, he that raised of Christ from the dead shall quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit, which dwells in you. So through the power of Christ's resurrection from the dead, you are delivered from the clutches of death. You are set free from the grip of death. And not just about, I'm talking about even untimely death. You are set free from the shackles of untimely death. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Every evil transaction concerning your life, everything that the devil has signed, sealed, and delivered concerning your life by the power of the resurrection of Christ from the dead, you are set free.
Yeah.
The chains are broken.
Yeah.
The chains are broken.
Yeah.
The chains of death are broken.
Yeah.
So not only are you separate from the clutches of death, even the second death has to pass over you. Because you are begotten of God. Said, thou art my son. Today, have I begotten. Because you are not only that. You become the begotten of the Father. You are baptized in His name. And it is something that you do by the power of the Holy Spirit in you. So it is something you do, you know, you do it effortlessly. It becomes part of your subconscious and conscious. So you take a conscious effort. Hallelujah. Yes, amen. God has become your master. That will be your portion in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, we have life, and we can declare boldly that we are more than conquerors, and we access all that pertains to life and godliness. I want to declare, I am more than conqueror.
I am more than conqueror.
By the resurrection of Christ from the dead, I am more than conqueror. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection. Not I will be. Said, I am the resurrection. Not just do I resurrect, not just do I raise the dead and make them alive. I am the resurrection. I am not just the keeper of life. I am the life. I am the embodiment of life. He said, he that believes in me, even though he were dead, yet shall he live again. Hallelujah. I believe,
I live in Christ.
I don't care whatever is happening in your life. I want you to declare the word of God concerning your life with your own mouth. He has given you a plan. I am the resurrection and the life. Whatever is dead in your life, things will come alive. Whatever ministry, career, whatever business, whatever it is that is dead, will come alive.
Amen.
The Lord, I believe your word. Be it from me according to the word. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let's begin to declare the word of God.